गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ द लेसन 1.2 ऑन टू द समिट वी रीच द टॉप। ओपन योर बुक्स, पेज नंबर 18, पैराग्राफ नंबर 4, पेज नंबर 18, पैराग्राफ नंबर 4। नाउ आई विल रीड द पैराग्राफ, concentrate on it. Page number 18, paragraph number 4. My first thought on reaching the top was a sense of gratitude to God. Gratitude means krutagnyata vyakta karne. Of gratitude to God that after having failed 6 times, He had blessed me with fulfillment of this desire I had held so long. Last period we have seen that Tenzin Norgay and Edmund Hillary also reached on the top of the Mount Everest. They also reached on the summit of Mount Everest. After reaching, there was a thought in the mind of Tenzin Norgay that he felt gratitude towards God, because before it he had tried 6 times to climb up Mount Everest, but every time he had failed, and for the 7th attempt he had got success, and he thought that, Tenzin Norgay thought that God had blessed him with fulfillment of that desire, of his desire. According to Tenzin Norgay, God had blessed him with fulfillment of his desire to reach on the summit of Mount Everest. याच्या पूर्वी तेंजिंग नॉर्गेनं माउंट एव्हरेस्ट शिखर सर करण्यासाठी 6 वेळा प्रयत्न केले होते, परंतु 6 वेळा त्याला अपयश आलेलं होतं, आणि या 7व्या प्रयत्नात मात्र त्याला यश आल्यानंतर माउंट एव्हरेस्टच्या शिखरावर पोचल्यावर पहिल्यांदा त्यानं काय कृती केली असेल, तर देवाप्रती कृतज्ञता व्यक्त केलेली आहे, आणि त्याचं जे स्वप्न साकार झालेलं आहे हे केवळ देवाचाच आशीर्वाद आहे, देवानंच त्याला ही परिपूर्ती दिलेली आहे असं तो मत व्यक्त करतो. आय प्लेस्ड ऑन द समीट द ऑफरिंग्स. ऑफरिंग्स म्हणजे प्रसाद. Offerings to God that I had carried with me, this is an accord. Write down new word, accord. Accord. Accord means consistent with. Chashi susavad sadhane. Ekmatana ekhadyashi susavad sadhane. This is in accord with my religion, dharma, both of my wife and I are Buddhist. I could not kneel, write down new word, kneel means bent down, gudghe vakun, kiwa gudghyavar basun, abhivadan karne. I could not kneel because of my clothes and equipment, but I offered a silent prayer in my heart. The offerings were biscuits, candy means goya, candy, and a little blue pencil. My youngest daughter Nima had given me the pencil before I left home. She asked me to put it on the top of the mountain as her offering. It was an ordinary blue pencil, not even a long one, but it was one of her prized possessions. When Tenzin Norgay with Edmund Hillary reached on the summit of Mount Everest, he felt gratitude towards God and he offered offerings to God. On the top of Mount Everest, he had placed offerings because he and his wife were Buddhist, and both of them also consistent with their religion. Actually, Tenzing Norgay wanted to kneel down, bend down to say or to pray to God, but his bulky clothes and equipment, he could not kneel and pray to God, but he had offered a silent prayer in his mind from his heart. On the top of Mount Everest, he had placed his offerings, biscuits, candy, and little blue pencil. That little blue pencil was offered by his little daughter Nima. She had given that blue pencil to Tenzing Norgay before he had left his home, and Nima also asked him to put that pencil on the top of mountain as her own offering. It was only an ordinary simple blue pencil, not long one, but that pencil was one of her prized possessions. लेखकानं माउंट एव्हरेस्टच्या शिखरावर पोचल्यानंतर देवाप्रती कृतज्ञता व्यक्त केली आणि देवाला प्रसाद म्हणून काही बिस्किटं गोळ्या आणि लेखकाची छोटी मुलगी निमा हिनं तिच्या स्वतःजवळ असणारा जो खजिना आहे त्या खजिन्यातली एक साधी निळ्या रंगाची पेन्सिल ही या माउंट एव्हरेस्टवर ठेवण्यासाठी दिलेली आहे आणि या वस्तू या ठिकाणी तेंजिंग नॉर्गेनं माउंट एव्हरेस्टच्या शिखरावर ठेवलेल्या आहेत. As I put it down, I pointed it out to Hilary. He gave me a big smile, showing that he understood. When Tenzing Norgay had offered a blue pencil of his youngest daughter Nima at that time, he had showed to Edmund Hillary that he had put this pencil on the top of Mount Everest. At that time, Edmund Hillary given a big smile and he understood the feelings of Tenzing Norgay. Then I got out the flags which I had and piece of string about 4 feet long. I fastened one end to my ice axe and Hillary took pictures as I held it up. As I had to bring my ice axe down with me, I buried one end of the string in the ice on the top and the other in snow on the slope down below. When we left, they were lying flat against the summit. After placing the offerings, Tenzing Norgay got out the flags of the four nations and he had on piece of string about 4 feet long to every flag. He had fastened one end to his ice axe and Edmund Hillary also took pictures of Tenzing Norgay which he had held those four flags in the air. After then, he had to bring his ice axe down with him. So he had buried one end of the string in the ice on the top and another end of the string also buried on the slope down below. And they left. They were lying flat against the summit. देवापुढे प्रसाद ठेवल्याच्या नंतर तेंजिंग नॉर्गे यांनी आपल्याजवळ असणारे चारही देशाचे ध्वज बाहेर काढलेत आणि ते उंच हवेत फडकवल्यानंतर एडमंड हिलरीने त्याचे फोटो घेतलेत आणि त्यानंतर म्हणजे उंच हवेत फडकवण्यासाठी तेंजिंग नॉर्गे यानं आपल्याजवळ असणारी आईस ॲक्स बर्फ तोडून काढण्यासाठी असणारी जी कुऱ्हाड आहे ती कुऱ्हाड वापरलेली होती, परंतु ज्यावेळेला प्रत्यक्ष ते ध्वज रोवण्यासाठी त्यानं वापर काय केलेला आहे तर त्यानं आपली असणारी कुऱ्हाड आपल्यासोबत खाली त्याला आणायची आहे, म्हणून प्रत्येक ध्वजाला अगदी 4 फूट लांबीचा असणारा जो दोरा आहे त्यातला एक वरचा टोक वरच्या बाजूच्या बर्फामध्ये रुतवून ठेवलेलं आहे आणि खालचं टोक खालच्या बाजूला बर्फामध्ये अगदी पुरून किंवा रुतवून ठेवलेलं आहे आणि त्यानंतर ते या असणाऱ्या शिखरावरती नतमस्तक होऊन ते त्यांनी हे शिखर सोडायचा किंवा सोडायला तयारीत आहेत. I was very thirsty. Thirsty म्हणजे ताणलेला. I took out a water tumbler for a drink, but found the water in the metal container had frozen. Frozen means गोठलेलं. Had frozen, so I couldn't quench my thirst. Quench. Write down new word. Quench. 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 Satisfy one's thirst. एखाद्याची तहान भागवणं, एखाद्याची तहान शमवणं. I couldn't quench my thirst. I ate some biscuits and offered some to Hilary. Tenzing Norgay was very thirsty on the top of Mount Everest. So he had took out his water container which was made up of metal. But he found that the water in the metal container was totally frozen and he could not drink water. He could not quench his thirst at that time. So he had eaten some biscuits and offered some biscuits to Edmund Hillary. I was wearing a red scarf which my great friend Lambert, leader of 1952 Swiss expedition, had given me last year. It was just a year ago on May 28th when we were standing at 28,215 feet that he gave me the scarf. I wore it all the way up the mountain from Darjeeling. As I stood at the top, I remembered him and felt that he was with me. I felt absolutely fit at the summit. My mind was absolutely clear. I didn't feel tired, damlela, thaklela. I didn't feel tired. I felt exhilarated. Write down new word, exhilarated. Exhilarated means excited or happy. खूप उत्तेजित होणे, खूप आनंदित होणे. I felt exhilarated. It was a very clear sensation. In this two paragraph we see that Tenzing Norgay was wearing a red scarf which scarf was gifted him his great friend Lambert. Lambert, who was leader of 1952 Swiss expedition a last year. We see that Lambert, who was the leader of the 1952 Swiss expedition, was a great friend of Tenzing Norgay, also gifted one of a red scarf a last year, and that red scarf was wearing Tenzing Norgay from Darjeeling to the top of summit of Mount Everest, and he thought that his friend Lambert was present at that time in the form of red scarf on the summit of Mount Everest. He remembered one of the memory through a red scarf. This red scarf was given by Lambert just a year ago on May 28th when both of them were standing at 28,215 feet, and Tenzing Norgay also wearing this red scarf from Darjeeling to the top of Mount Everest, and he felt that Lambert was with him on the summit of Mount Everest. On the last point, he felt He was absolutely fit and fine on the summit. He felt very happy and he became very excited. His mind was absolutely clear and his sensation was also clear. या दोन पॅरेग्राफमध्ये आपल्याला रेड स्कार्फबद्दल सांगितलेलं आहे. तेनझिंग नॉर्गे यांचा असणारा जो मित्र त्याचं नाव आहे लंबर्ट, की जो 1952 साली स्विस मोहिमेमध्ये लीडर होता. त्या लंबर्ट या लेखकाच्या मित्रानं लेखकाला 28,215 फुटावर 28 मेल दोघे उभे राहिलेले असताना हा रेड स्कार्प गिफ्ट म्हणून दिलेला आहे आणि तो स्कार्प दार्जिलिंगपासून माउंट एव्हरेस्टवर पोचेपर्यंत त्यानं तो वापरलेला आहे किंवा परिधान केलेला आहे. आणि त्यामुळं हा लंबर्ट आपल्यासोबतच आपल्याबरोबर या मोहिमेत आहे असा भास त्याला झालेला आहे. ही मोहीम पत्ती झाल्यानंतर किंवा शिखरावर पोचल्यानंतर लेखक स्वतः आपलं अनुभव व्यक्त करतोय की या शिखरावरती तो तब्येतीनं अगदी फिट आणि फाईन आहे. त्याचं मन ही अगदी क्लिअर आहे आणि तो अत्यंत उत्तेजित आणि आनंदी झालेला आहे. म्हणजेच त्याचं जे समाधान आहे हे समाधान या ठिकाणी त्यानं व्यक्त केलेलं दिसून येतं. बिलो ऑल द हिल्स अँड माउंटेन्स लुकड लाईक गॉड्स अँड गॉडेसेस टू मी. द प्लेन्स बिलो लुकड लाईक सो मेनी ब्रोकन पीसेस ऑफ द मॅप. On the top of Mount Everest, Tenzing Norgay saw all the backgrounds and all the landscape. According to Tenzing Norgay, all the hills and the mountains which he had looked like from the top of the Mount Everest looked like as a god and goddesses, and the plains from the top of Mount Everest also looked like many broken pieces of the map. Two or three people could stand there on the roof of the world. If you cut ice 20 or 30 feet below the top, there was enough flat square for two people to sleep. You could pitch one tent there. Tent manje tambu. Pitch one tent, tambu ubharne. The summit is flat on one side and steep on the other. There is snow on northern side, rocks on the south and east, and snowy rock on the west. We stayed on the top a little more than 15 minutes. We were lucky that there was no gale. Gale, strong wind. वादळी वारा. गेल मीन्स स्ट्रॉंग विंड, वादळी वारा. वी वेर लकी दॅट देअर वॉज नो गेल ऑर इट वुड हॅव स्वेप्ट अस ऑफ. माय नेक्स्ट थॉट वॉज हाऊ टू गेट डाऊन सेफली. हिअर तेनझिंग नॉर्गे अल्सो डिस्क्राइब्ड ॲक्च्युअल एरिया ऑर द सर्फेस ऑफ द समिट ऑफ माउंट एव्हरेस्ट. According to Tenzing Norgay, on the roof of the world, the surface was possibly stand only 2 or 3 persons. 20 or 30 feet below the top, there was enough flat square for only 2 people to sleep. On the top of Mount Everest, there was enough surface for only 2 people, and there one could also pitch tent. The summit is flat on one side and steep on the other. There was snow on the northern side, rocks on the south side and the east, and snowy rock on the west. So Tenzing Norgay and Edmund Hillary also stayed on the summit of Mount Everest only 15 minutes. And he felt that both of them were lucky because there was no strong wind. Otherwise, they would have swept through this gale. Now Tenzing Norgay felt worried about to get down safely. या पॅरेग्राफमध्ये आपल्याला माउंट एव्हरेस्ट याचा वरचा जो सरफेस आहे, पृष्ठभाग आहे, त्याच्याबद्दलची माहिती मिळते. तर या उंच शिखरावरती, जगाचं उंच टोप, याच्यावरती फक्त 2 ते 3 व्यक्तींना उभं राहता येईल एवढीच जागा त्या ठिकाणी आहे. तिथून खाली थोडंसं 20 ते 30 फुटावर आल्यानंतर 2 लोकांना झोपण्याकरता जागा मिळावी एवढीच जागा उपलब्ध आहे. त्या ठिकाणी तुम्ही तंबू ठोकून राहू शकता किंवा थांबू शकता. परंतु या तेंजिंग नॉर्गेनं वर्णन केलेलं जे शिखर आहे, त्याच्या शिखराची जी एक बाजू आहे ती सपाट आहे, दुसरी बाजू जी आहे ती खोल निवळती उतरती आहे, आणि एका उत्तरेच्या बाजूला पूर्णपणे बर्फ आहे, तर दक्षिण आणि पूर्वेच्या बाजूला खडक आहे, आणि पश्चिमेच्या बाजूला मात्र पुन्हा बर्फाळ असे खडक आहेत. फक्त 15 मिनटं एडमंड हिलरी आणि तेंजिंग नॉर्गे त्या ठिकाणी थांबलेत, आणि त्यांच्या निशेबानं त्यावेळी अत्यंत वादळी वारा नव्हता आणि त्यामुळे ते 15 मिनटं थांबू शकलेत. आता त्यांना पुढचा प्रश्न, यक्षप्रश्न आहे की सुरक्षितपणे खाली उतरणार. ऑन द डिसेंट, डिसेंट मीन्स खाली उतरणे. ऑन द डिसेंट फ्रॉम द समिट आय वॉज वॉकिंग बिहाइंड हिलरी. आय वॉज फॉलोइंग हिम अँड होल्डिंग द रोप टाईटली. अँड माय डिटर्मिनेशन वॉज टू मेक, डिटर्मिनेशन निश्चय, अँड माय डिटर्मिनेशन वॉज टू मेक शुअर ही डिसेंडेड सेफली. आय मस्ट से दॅट द क्लाइम्ब डाऊन वॉज मोर डिफिकल्ट अँड डेंजरस दॅन द क्लाइम्ब अप. इफ यू स्लिप्ड डाऊन यू वुड गो इन टू कांगशोंग ग्लेसियर. कांगशोंग ग्लेसियर, कांगशोंग हे नाव आहे ग्लेसियर हिमनदी, ग्लेसियर मीन्स हिमनदी. कांगशोंग ग्लेसियर अँड देअर वुड बी नो ट्रेस, ट्रेस म्हणजे शोध मागमूस. देअर वुड बी नो ट्रेस लेफ्ट टू यू. नाऊ एडमंड हिलरी अँड तेंजिंग नॉर्गे वॉज रेडी टू लेफ्ट समिट ऑफ माउंट एव्हरेस्ट. तेंजिंग नॉर्गे वॉज वॉकिंग बिहाइंड हिलरी. He was followed him and holding the rope tightly. Tenzing Norgay's determination was to make sure to get down safely and securely. And he must say that, according to Tenzing Norgay, he say that climb down was more difficult and dangerous than the climb up. According to Tenzing Norgay, climb up is easy than climb down because there was a chances of slipped down and you would go into Kangshung Glacier and there would be no any trace of someone. More caution needed. Adhik Savadgiri Garjechi. Of course, it took less time climbing down, but you needed more fujiyar. Fujiyar.
Fujiyar means caution,
neat, savdhanta, khabardari. Needed more fujiyar when I reached the camp 9. My first thought was, thank God, we have been spared an accident. And if up to now there have been no accidents, I hope there will be none in future. I had always prayed to God and He had saved me. Now, Tenzing Norgay and Edmund Hillary also followed themselves and they also pray to God to get down safely and securely. According to both of them, more caution needed. According to Tenzing Norgay, to climb down took less, according to Tenzing Norgay, to climb up and climb down, climb down process also take less time than the climb up, but the process of climb down also needed more and more caution. When Tenzing Norgay and Edmund Hillary also reached the camp 9, at that time he prayed to God and also felt a gratitude towards God that he had spared, he and Edmund Hillary had spared from any accident. And hope so in future he will also spared from accidents. According to Tenzing Norgay, in future he will not face any accident because of God only. And he also thanked God who had saved him from any accidents. तेंजिंग नार्गेच्या मते वर चढणं हे सोपं असलं तरी खाली उतरणं हे खूप अवघड आहे. वर चढायला खूप वेळ लागतो परंतु खाली उतरायला कमी वेळ लागत असला तरीसुद्धा खाली उतरताना खूप खबरदारी घ्यावी लागते. कारण खाली उतरत असताना पाय घसरला तर तुम्ही अगदी थेट एखाद्या कांगशुंग हिम नदीमध्ये थेट पडू शकता आणि तुमचा तिथं पत्ताही लागू शकत नाही. ज्या वेळेला हे दोघेजण नव्या कॅम्पवर पोचले त्यावेळी तेंजिंग नॉर्गेनं देवाचे आभार मानलेत की आमच्यासोबत कसलाही अपघात झाला नाही आणि भविष्यात तो होणार नाही याबद्दल देवाचे आभार मानले. ॲट अ कॅम्प नाईन हिलरी अँड आय वी आर इन नो मूड फॉर एनी टॉकिंग. वी जस्ट अटेंडेड टू अवर ओन थिंग्स. वी स्टेड देअर अबाउट हाफ एन अवर. वी बॉइल्ड सम स्नो टू मेक लेमन water and drank it. When we left, we took only our sleeping bags and left everything else behind in the tent. From camp 9 to camp 8, where we spent the night, was an easier job. Just above camp 8, where the others could see us, I raised my arm with my thumb up. CWF Noisy at WG Louis saw us and their faces flushed with joy. In this way, I was able to tell them of our success as we got nearer to Camp 8. Louis came to meet us and came up about 300 feet with tea and coffee. Tenzing Norgay and Edmund Hillary also reached Camp 9, but both of them were in no mood for any talking, so they also attended their own things. They stayed there only half an hour at the 9 camp. Both of them also boiled some snow to make lemon juice and they also drank it. When they left, they took only sleeping bags and left everything at the 9 camp behind in the tent. From camp 9 to 8, to camp 8, where they spent the night, was very easier job. Above camp 8, where all the members also see easily them, and Tenzing Norgay also raised his arm with his thumb, and Noisy and Louis saw them and their faces became very happy. In this way, Tenzing Norgay also showed their success to all the people when they got nearer to Camp 8, Louis came to meet them, came up about 300 feet with tea and coffee. Another 50 feet down, we met Noisy, who brought us more tea. This tea smelled kerosene rockel. Apparently, it had been made in a hurry. Hurry means ghai. In a hurry, and somehow some kerosene got into the welcome cup. But I thought, since the gentleman had taken so much trouble to bring it, I was going to enjoy it, whatever the smell. In above paragraph, we say that 300 feet above, Louis also came with tea and coffee for Tenzing and Edmund Hillary. And another 50 feet down, Noisy also came with more tea. But this tea was smelled kerosene. Clearly, in a hurry and a flurry, some kerosene also got into the welcome cup and it was smelled it. But Tenzing Norgay and Edmund Hillary also drank this tea, which was smelled by kerosene, happily, because they thought that the gentleman who also take hard work and trouble to mate the tree and also brought up to 50 feet of for them. So Tenzing Norgay also drank it very happily, and he also enjoyed this kerosene tea, whatever the smell. या दोन पॅरेग्राफमध्ये आपण पाहिले की ज्यावेळेला तेंजिंग नॉर्गे आणि एडमंड हिलरी हे दोघेजण नव्या कॅम्पवर पोचल्यानंतर ते दोघेही एकमेकाशी बोलण्याच्या मनस्थितीत नव्हते. त्यांनी आपापली कामं उरकल्यानंतर, दैनंदिन आपली कामं उरकल्यानंतर, काही बर्फ उकळला आणि त्याच्यातून लिंबू पाणी दोघांनीही पिलेलं आहे. त्यानंतर फक्त झोपण्याच्या बॅग्स घेऊन बाकी सर्व साहित्य तंबूमध्ये, नव्या कॅम्पमधल्या तंबूमध्ये ठेवून ते खाली उतरत होते. ज्यावेळेला ते आठव्या कॅम्पकडं येत आहेत की ज्या ठिकाणी त्यांना एक रात्र घालवायची आहे, त्या ठिकाणावरून तेंजिंग नॉर्गेनं खाली असणाऱ्या लोकांप्रती हात उंचावून आपला असणारा जो अंगठा, येस वी हॅव डन इट अशा अर्थानं ज्यावेळेला दाखवला, त्यावेळी खाली असणारी जी या मोहिमेतली जी इतर मंडळी होती, त्यामध्ये लुई आणि त्याचबरोबर नॉयसी जे आहेत, त्यांचे चेहरे अत्यंत आनंदाने उजळून गेलेत. आणि मग अत्यंत आनंदानं लुई जो आहे तो अगदी आठव्या कॅम्पपर्यंत 300 फूटवर एडमंड हिलरी आणि तेंजिंग नॉर्गे यांच्यासाठी चहा तयार करून घेऊन आलेला आहे. त्यानंतर हे दोघेजण खाली उतरत असताना आणखी 50 फूट खाली आल्यानंतर नॉयसी हा स्वतः चहा तयार करून घेऊन त्या तेंजिंग नॉर्गे आणि एडमंड हिलरीसाठी घेऊन आलेला आहे. घाईगडबडीत थोडंसं रॉकेल केरोसिन त्या चहामध्ये सांडलेलं असावं आणि त्यामुळे त्या चहाला तशा पद्धतीचा रॉकेलचा वास येत होता. परंतु तेंजिंग नॉर्गे विचार काय करतायत की तो चहा तयार करताना घेतलेला परिश्रम आणि 50 फूट वर चढून येण्याचा परिश्रम या सद्गृहास्ते आभारच मानून आपण हा अगदी केरोसिनयुक्त असणारा चहासुद्धा पिला पाहिजे, आणि त्यांना धन्यवाद देत हा केरोसिनयुक्तसुद्धा चहा पिलेला आहे. स्टुडंट्स, नाऊ यू विल रीड धिस लेसन फ्रॉम द बॉटम ऑफ हार्ट ॲट अ होम अँड ऑल्सो राईट डाऊन सम क्वेश्चन्स from brainstorming. Thank you.